document review is where now we're relying on certain guidelines. Document review means we are just looking at the already existing one. So a document review involves examining HR records, policies, procedures to assess compliance, but also to have a basis because we also want to understand how the history has been. Have we been consistent? I mean, over time certain things have run, have changed. But also to know the basis of certain problems. It could be that some problems that you're facing in an organization is because of something illegal here now. Okay? So you find that sometimes the company doesn't want to investigate, to do a document review, to understand in terms of how the past being handled. So in short, we're simply looking at in terms of the HR records. Okay? So in terms of the advantages, that obviously this is historical data, so it basically reviews in terms of the past record, but it also tells us in terms of what has been the trend and what has been the what. The so for you to know that how consistent this particular person is, you can look at again the history in terms of the certain trends or patterns over time. What do you think it would be a disadvantage of using document review?
History doesn't live in the future, so history is seen as a ground.
Yes. Although people say,
I'm a gentleman, but you're both a good and a good.
History repeats itself. Right? Mm-hmm. Some people say that.
But somebody, somebody in the audit that I do with the Missouri, you know, being noticed the actual problem at that time.
At that particular time.
Yeah.
Because you've been focusing on the past,
right? Yeah.
And not looking at the present.
Mm-hmm. I like that view.
So yeah, we find that you're more focused on what has been happening in the past other than the current. So it's important that you need to be more focused on the current issues and record that. But also sometimes the way you're doing the document review, you find that sometimes the data may be incomplete. When a document you are not even being the reason in it again.
The summary is reading that document, where some information has been omitted. But also remember that some documents or reports, they are written to specific people for specific reasons. Report you want to submit to a finance person, report you want to submit to an administrator, cannot be in the same language. They have to be put in such a way that somebody should run, should understand. So I went to my university for some time. I'm on the very beach for a short period of time, long for my investigation, I'm a countdown and time. So my bank statement. So I was not can give me as a report. And then his master told me of just a way to that he also came to me. Can you also give me a report? I said, but now one day I'll give the true word information, including whether that or in a drama in that amount of okay or so on. But somebody who is a head teacher, you wouldn't want to disclose such kind of thing.
Variations in terms of the quantity of the data that are being provided, the records. You find that some offices or some departments, they're not good at record keeping.
That's true.
Yeah. So you go there and find this, like, there's nothing. Yeah, because I already went from Guru Nash. Guru Nash is the one who saw it. You don't have anything to wear to start from. In such cases, it might affect how reliable this data may be. But also, as a disadvantage, is lack of context, as you have said, it's talking about the past, not talking about the things and the current situation. And also, sometimes it might be difficult for you to get a whole complete picture. Everybody is because you're not present, What really caused for that to happen may have been forgotten on what has caused for such things to happen. So there's lack of context. So to have a complete picture in terms of what is happening on the ground. Okay? So because of that, we're looking at that also. Another tool that we can also depend on is the HR information system, HRIS. Yeah? So whether you have a database within the organization where people can access, this can also be a tool that we can use also to look at the database, look at the information that has been stored in the information system. So the advantage is that yes, it's efficient, because you're able to get all the necessary data in a very short period of time. It's also real-time data because people are entering it immediately, it's getting into the cloud, isn't it? Immediately it's going into your database. So it means you can access up-to-date and channel information. Yeah, but also the data integrity in terms of that, the accuracy is there, but also the information is also wide. The disadvantage of this is to come up with the HRIS system, a database within the organization may also be costly for the organization. Okay? So you find that some organizations may not really go for coming up with an HR
information system.
Yeah. Because it might be costly for them to set up and it is also expensive. Yeah. Sometimes also there might be data security concerns. Yeah? Privacy, security issues, some information that you don't want to disclose to everyone. For example, that my numbers are available in the cloud. So because it's in the cloud, it means if someone just puts in the password, they get access to almost everything. Okay? So again, there might be problems in terms of security. Some systems actually, even people maybe they need training on how they should access those particular information. For example, maybe it's a software package and you're not convinced on how to use that package, you find that some people may need to be oriented or trained on how they can access in terms of this information system. So it is also a disadvantage that some people may need the training itself. Number five, the last one, we are looking at that again, the issues of focus group one. FTD, yes?
Focus group discussion. FTD. Focus group discussion.
The smaller the group, the easier to manage it.
So the same also you are as a researcher, you have to make sure that again, if the group that you can basically start and it should be safe after fall and nothing exceeding that.
So focus group involves a small group discussion guided by a moderator, the researcher, to explore specifically. So moderator, because it has to be guided.
Notice that you're giving them a topic, yes? Yeah. But I didn't have a big and you was kind of some of this. Yeah, I have some Japanese many more things to be just a robot. What do you mean? So, which means that as a researcher, you have to be very on top of things, because otherwise, you will leave people discussing things that are irrelevant. So that's why we are using the word moderate. You are moderating, because you need to be what? Guiding them. So what is it that we want to basically discuss?
Okay, so as you can see, if you're moderating, the higher the group, it becomes difficult to moderate. The smaller the group, the easier. What would be the advantages and disadvantages of using a focus group discussion? Also time consuming for planning and conducting the focus group itself. Yeah. ka je
kwanza na wewe six calls
ah mimi basi huko kwanza na zuri
kwa information kwa maana of the report the way important issue so we couldn't ignore them. We decided we would do that to go back to pitch
so usually where the discussion or the meeting you find that it end up becoming time consuming because again a lot of people are bringing in also their ideas. But also as an advantage, we can look at that employees may also feel more engaged because they are basically working as a group. But also in a group, we are assuming that in that group again, we are going to have people that have diverse experiences. So about their personal opinion, we are going to number based on their own personal experience, which cannot be the same for everyone. Yeah, so for that case, we will be able to generate also more information because everyone will be talking about based on their level of understanding and scenarios that maybe they have come across, eh? Of which we know, hey, that's not what we come across, but someone else has. Okay? So, it is both an advantage as well as a suite and the last one is this where we were talking about observation.
That's not a fix.
Right?
Yes.
So observation involves directly watching each other processes and practices in action. As the word suggests, watch. So the advantage there is that again you can get behavioral insight because it provides direct observation of each other practices while it is happening in action. And so you're able to get in terms of the behavior or what people actually do, or what actually people show in terms of behavior. So you're able to get behavioral insight. What about in terms of business advantages? So some employees may not feel comfortable being observed. For example, I am one of them. I don't like when I'm doing something that is just like I'm aware. It's not really me, I don't want to. Even when I was a student, I used to hate that in the beginning, right? That you're right and it's done, and the guy just comes and stands next to you like that. It seems very intimidating, eh? And it makes you not comfortable with your own personal space. You know, you want your space. You want your breather. You don't want that every, spinning, water, walking, violin, you want to be comfortable with doing it on your own. Yeah. Despite that, yes, someone is intimidating, but doesn't necessarily mean that they have to police you even as you are writing. They can observe you even at work. And it just says, isn't it? Yes, without even taking up your own personal space. So sometimes you find that some people are very uncomfortable that they are being observed. Although even in observation, sometimes you have two options, whether you disclose, that we are going to be observing you, or is it something that is done privately? You're just investigating something without even people knowing that you are actually present. So there are two things about it. But where you are saying that you would warn them in advance, it means they'll behave in a certain way because they know that we are being what? We're being observed. It's just in the same as the offices. Because you know that I'm the one. But where you know you're not being seen, you can do all sorts of things on Facebook, we check out your email, we'll say it's all sorts of things because you know that you're not being observed. But also another disadvantage that there's a limited scope in terms of that not all HR processes can easily be observed. And not everything can be observed. There's something that is difficult for you to observe. So whether it's about students' performance, for example, how they write their assignment, are you going to be able to observe that? That's fine. When you go to your room, mama, bring my assignment, come on your back. Just as well, I Google a bit of site, abuse it, how do they analyze the information, how do they write the final assignment. It's difficult just to observe all that.
Ah, sorry,
That's a good encouragement.
what we have discussed in your signing, is that I think I've got about 7 job routine. That's why I was busy following up with that. Do you have two numbers that you have in court? Do you really need one? What is the exact number? So what we have agreed is that on the TNM, TNM will work on a daily bundle, because we don't want to be in a Sharia and then it will be a cost on our time. Yeah, so she proposed really what an assistant was. I think you may make 110 million a day. Yeah? So that we should be observing on a daily basis. We've now reached the sample size that we're looking for. Yes. So, however, the list you may want to extract, Manama Bamana Fana GM account. So that's why I'm asking you for a TNM number. So the reason why I'm spending is because I want to send the airtime now to your TNM line. So I don't want to wish to be surprised and not to be sent by the Friday. So it's just like a control we should be seeing on a daily basis with when we do when we be the cutoff point. But we would have loved putting on a carry in all of the thing and the night.
programming is not part of the problem, you don't need to say that so much. Because we're going to have to do as a wish. So many days ago, Zoro and Tower, I told her, pull a man and a visitor. Hey, we're going to have to do
Thank you. Okay.